Well, you tell them that a woman is entitled to have a mood, any mood, a happy mood, a sad mood, an angry mood, and she can have this mood whenever she likes. And it has absolutely nothing to do with whether or not Aunt Flo is visiting. And one more thing, these people should be very happy that women get visits from their aunts, because if they didn't, there would be no uncles.
Your face, soft yet fierce. A tiger's paw, claws available as necessary. The sharp slit of your eyes, the swift draw of your switchblade tongue, spikes for eyebrows, the way you raise them, as precise as the way you've raised America's children. This poem is for Claire Huxtable. Motherhood requires ninja training, and you are a master. Your killer smile, your chuckles like nunchucks, knocking nonsense to its knees, kicking the butt of every joke. Oh, how brave is a sitcom for challenging you from week to week with its weakness for women with more funny bone than backbone. Even with an army of laugh tracks trailing your every move, your skills too much for them. The live studio audience never stood a fighting chance. You had them in stitches. They all just died laughing, cracked harder than the 80s did to neighborhoods right up the block from where you lived. 10 Stigwood Avenue, 10 Leroy Street. You weren't even that funny. More like ferocious, more like your beauty a beast, your mind a crouching tiger, your smile a hidden dragon, your word a swift leopard, your grace a flying crane, your style a sacred snake, a panther, a cobra, a mantis, and we were all your prayer. What do you call that move again? The one where you took the entire country by the arm, wrapped it around your little finger, and body slammed it up against the television set without so much as even breaking a nail. Yes, that one. I think you called it the lawyer. Or maybe it was the lover. Or maybe it was that I'm about to make this meal, win this case, write this song, wrap my arms around my Heathcliff, make Theo clean his room, let Sandra move back in again, ship Denise off to a different world, help Vanessa find her swagger, all in enough time to sit down and eat dinner at the table with the whole family after saying grace in Spanish. Ay, Dios mío, qué tipo de mujer eres. You, the sole reason I keep a television handy, the fat kind with a VCR. Flat screens are not big-boned enough for your thick wit. In one episode, Rudy gets her period. You declared it Woman's Day. She was ashamed. The way most little girls are taught to be ashamed when our bodies become the punctuation for the statement that our lives are making. In this moment, you became grandmother, gave her a lesson in grammar, taught her that she hails from a lineage of subjects who flip verbs so hard we ain't had to be nobody's object. Now our sentence structure is immaculate, check it, or set, period, Oshun, period. Ma'at, period, Harriet, period, Maya, period, Nina, period, Ruby, period, Alice, period, Octavia, period, Michelle, period, Camille, period, my mama, period, Felicia, period. Sabrina Fulton, period. Wanda Johnson, period. and every unnamed mother whose sons have been slaughtered into fragments, their daughters stripped and taken from themselves before they could get to their own period. Your girls wanted to play dress up in your clothes. But the world wanted to play dress up in your skin. Feel the soul inside your character, the freedom beneath your tailored suits. Know the comforts of your plush bed and silken sheets. We yearned for you to make your bed just so we could lie in it the way you went to sleep in full makeup. Yes, we noticed. We longed to lick each one of your fingers as if they were our own. Savor whatever you pretended to be cooking in those red pots all these years. Claire, I am clear. We needed to taste the truth of just how unreal you really are. Sincerely. In training.
And if you don't get it together and drop these macho attitudes, you are never gonna have anybody bringing you anything, anywhere, anyplace, anytime, ever.